Hi everyone, welcome back to another Animal Crossing New Horizons video. So in today's video, we're back with another fairy home speed build. If you weren't aware, I've already done many episodes in this series. I've made a flower fairy home, a water fairy home, a light fairy home, and now we are finally making my favorite fairy, an animal fairy's home. I thought an animal fairy's home would be so perfect for this time of year. I'm going to be talking the whole time I'm building anyway, so why don't we just get into it? Okay, so here we are. Just want to apologize before I start talking if you can hear any different noises in the background to usual. Archie is sat right next to me, like right next to the microphone. I literally just had to cut because he is like licking himself in the microphone, but he won't leave me alone. He's being really, really cuddly. I can't get him to leave me alone. Like literally, can you hear him in the background? So on screen right now, you should be able to see the images I used for inspiration. I was using Fawn's house from the Tinkerbell series because she's an animal fairy. So I looked up what her house looked like and I was using that as inspiration. And I was also using the animal fairy home from the old Tinkerbell games. I don't know if any of you used to play this, but I was absolutely in love with this game. It was like an online multiplayer game and you got to create a fairy character, you had your own house, you could buy clothes, chat to people, there was those little quests. Unfortunately, it's not available to play anymore, though I think there is like a fan created one. I'm not sure, I really want to look into that. But when I used to play that game, I always made an animal fairy character. And so this was what my house would have looked like in the game. And I was using that as inspiration as well. So as you can tell, we're going with a lot of brown and orange this time around. I really wanted to include a lot of different animal themed items. I actually asked you guys on my Discord server if any of you had the recipes I needed, because I had absolutely like no recipes that would go well with this house, but I really wanted to build it. So some of you gave me the recipes for a lot of the autumn's bounty, I think that's what they're called, those recipes, because they're really hard to collect. I think those items are available to collect now as well, like currently right now in the game, because I think right now you can collect acorns and pine cones. But yeah, I had like none of them. So thank you so much to everyone on my Discord server that let me come visit that island and gave me the items I needed, because I really, really appreciate it. My plan for this house, I always envisioned having a big mushroom table in the middle, because it's the closest thing to like the little bird's nest type bed that's in one of the images I would have put on the screen already. And by the way, yes, I get asked a lot in these videos what type of fairy I think I'd be if I was one, and I always say I think I'd be an animal fairy. If I wasn't an animal fairy, I'd probably be maybe a snow fairy, maybe a flower fairy, but I'm not very good at gardening. I am getting better at keeping my houseplants alive, but I'm not the best at gardening. I had so much fun creating this build. I haven't filmed one of these fairy ones in a while because I've been doing villager home transformations. If you haven't seen those, you should definitely go check them out. Hopefully I'll be making some more of those soon. I also want to make a video actually playing New Horizons like properly soon, because I haven't played New Horizons properly on my channel in so long, so there's just been nothing to do. Hopefully I can think of something to do, especially now it's autumn time. It'll be so nice to just get cozy and play Animal Crossing together. Let me know in the comments what you've been up to. Other than planning on playing Animal Crossing and doing the speed build, I've been playing Cozy Grove and sharing that on the channel as well. I absolutely adore that game, it's so much fun. I did a Pocket Camp video too if you haven't checked that out already. Autumn time in Pocket Camp is so, so lovely. Yeah, I'm just really enjoying autumn time. It's still really warm here in the UK, which is kind of weird because usually the UK is freezing cold and raining all the time, but no, apparently it wants to be summer in autumn this year. I have no idea why. But yeah, I've been doing really well recently. I hope you guys are doing well. Oh, I should probably also say at the end of this video, I'll be showing off some of your guys' builds, because if you didn't know, in my Discord server, I do a weekly competition called the Happy Home Corner, where I give you guys a theme and you guys decorate a room in New Horizons or any Animal Crossing game you like, Pocket Camp as well if you like, but mostly New Horizons, and you basically have to create a room with that theme. I've been doing this for quite a while now, though I do tend to forget some weeks and forget to announce the winners sometimes and forget to give a new theme a lot of the time. But I do try my best, and this week the theme was Autumn Times Fantasy, because I was gonna give you guys the same theme as me to make like a autumny animal fairy house, but I thought some people might not want to make a fairy house, so I decided to go with a really broad theme, Autumn Times Fantasy. Yeah, at the end of this video, I'll be showing off some of your amazing builds. So if you're here for that, maybe there's a timestamp in the description if you want to just skip to that, but please don't. Please watch the whole video, it really helps me out. I've been trying my best to get more motivated recently. I've been trying to come up with like fun video ideas, and actually finding the motivation to make them has been a massive struggle for me. If you follow me on Instagram, you know I talk about the fact that I've been struggling with motivation for so long. And even one of my YouTube friends, Ben, said to me the other day, "I noticed you haven't been uploading very much. Are you okay?" I was like, I'm okay. I just, like, my motivation this year has just been so, it's been so weird. Like, sometimes I feel like I'm super motivated and inspired, and I have so many ideas. Like, I have a page on my phone that's just YouTube ideas. It's like my YouTube planner. Whenever I get around to actually making the videos, my body just does not want to, and I'm really struggling with motivation. And I thought I was gonna get better once autumn came around, but I still feel like I feel a bit better, but I just still feel a bit like I'm really struggling to do the work, mainly the editing. It takes so long. Like, I get tired so easily. You guys don't care. You guys don't want to hear about how tiring it is for me recently, but just know I am trying my best, and hopefully I get out of this slump soon. But I have just been a bit behind this entire year. I don't even think I uploaded a YouTube video till like February this year, so I was already behind as soon as the year started. But I also have my own flat now, and I take care of my flat, so I'm cleaning every day. I've got to run a house basically, so I am busy a lot of the time doing other things. And I've also just been exploring other hobbies. Like, since I moved out, I've had so much more time to read. So I've been reading a lot of books, and it's been so much fun because I haven't read properly in so many years because my attention span just kind of died off. But anyways, enough about my life and rambling about nonsense. The build. So my favorite item in this entire build is the pinecone mobile. Like, look how cute that item is. I love that item so much. Like, I really want to create that in my real life house. Like, can you imagine how cute that is? And it probably, you can get like all the items to make that from outside. I could probably go and find pine cones and sticks and make that myself. Will I? Probably not. But if I actually had the motivation, imagine how cute that would look in real life. And yeah, this build did get very messy very quickly. But in my head, I just like to think that animal fairies are quite messy because they're always trying to help animals and have items available to help animals in their home, and then animals live with them and stuff. So there's a lot of mess in this house, and it's probably one of the most messiest, I want to say, or most, maybe not messiest. I don't think it has the most clutter. I'm not too sure, but it feels a lot more cluttered than the other homes I've done, which were all quite cluttered as well. If it wasn't obvious, my style of decorating for fairy homes is just clutter because fairies do like to collect things, and so I think they would have a ton of stuff just in the house all the time. I've been using butterfly items, teddy bears, there's this little cat item that I use in my villager's home as like a pretend Archie in my house. I've put that in the house. I did have a puppy item in the home for a while, but then I got rid of that because it just wasn't fitting the vibe. But I also put like a lot of like snails and stuff like that, and I think I put a cricket and a dragonfly in the home as well. I also covered the place in plants because all the animals in her home would love the plants. I really love this home. This might be one of my favorites. I know the style isn't for everyone, but it really, like, as soon as I see this home, I think, oh, animal fairy, like immediately. I don't know if that's just because I'm a huge animal fairy fan. I don't know if that's the same for people who aren't super into the Tinkerbell universe, but as soon as I see this, I do just think of animal fairy. So I personally really like how it came out. Oh, you could probably also see me struggling with, like, do I keep a lot of these items in the home? Because I did put the Easter egg basket in the home because I thought it'd be so cute, like the animal fairies have been collecting eggs. But unfortunately it didn't quite fit the color scheme, and I just didn't have the room for it, so I had to get rid of that in the end. If the room was bigger, I would have loved to include it. And I also did something I don't usually do very much in these builds. At the end, I added a ton of designs that really helped the room come together, I think. If I can find the codes for these designs, I will try to put them in the description, though knowing me, I'll most likely forget. But I used some designs for like a bunny rabbit and a squirrel and birds. These are all designs that I actually use on my island in the game, though you guys haven't seen my island in quite a long time, so I should probably do an update soon. But yeah, I really did try to include a lot of animal designs, a lot of animal items, just make it seem like an animal fairy truly does live here and likes to bring back animals here to take care of them. You've probably also seen that I included a teddy bear and a big teddy bear. In my mind, it was like looking after a bear cub that's injured or something, so they're staying with her at the moment. Of course, her house would have to be absolutely ginormous for a real bear cub to be sat in her home, but you know, we can pretend. I did actually look very closely at the image of Fawn's house from the Tinkerbell series, and they have a page like talking about each item in the home basically. There was a teddy bear and it says that she has stuffed animals in her home, so I thought, of course animal fairies would have stuffed animals, not like actual stuffed animals, that would be horrific. Like, you know, teddy bears. I think animal fairies would have a teddy bear obsession, a bit like me. If you didn't know, I love teddy bears. My entire vision for this house was mushroom table, teddy bear. That was my entire idea when I went into this, so it may seem a bit miscombobulated. Is that a word? I don't know. Miscombobulated? Let me see if that's a word. 1 second. Miscombobulated. Discombobulated is the word. Characterized by confusion or disorder. In a sentence, he was discombobulated. Wow, I thought I just made that word up, but I didn't. Anyways, I've been talking for a long time. So, with all that rambling out of the way, let's look at the finished build. Okay, so here we are, and as you can see, I've dressed my character up like an animal fairy as well. I think this is the fairy outfit that actually suits my original character the most. I didn't have to change much about her. But here's what it looks like. And this is the finished home. So why don't we do a little tour? I think this came out so cozy, and I really did plan on using the autumn forest wallpaper, but I felt like it made the house seem too dark. I just went with this wooden beige color wallpaper in the end, and I think it feels so cozy and lovely. I hope you guys like it. So as you walk in, the first thing you see is the Autumn's Bounty archway and the festival garland thing. I love that item so much. And so over here we have a little daisy shower for her pet duck to enjoy. I can just imagine the duck ruffling his little feathers underneath the shower and really enjoying it. And she has a cherry lamp, some vines growing into the wall, and she also has this mushroom table and little leaf stool. I think she'd use this as a desk, a vanity table, and things like that. But at the moment it has this cute little acorn toy on it. And she also is taking care of a little cricket at the moment. And she has this beautiful golden plant by the window, which I absolutely love this item. And I think it's so perfect for an animal fairy's home. And in the top left corner, we have her bedroom. So she has a brown dreamy bed with her mushroom dress hanging on the wall. Of course, the pinecone mobile, lots of flowers and mushrooms. She even has a little pinecone tree. This item's a little bit Christmassy, but I don't think it's too Christmassy that we can't use it all year round. And of course, she has the windflower fan as well, which keeps her room nice and cool. In the right hand corner, we have the big daddy bear and the little baby bear. And I think she'd be taking care of both of these animals. We also have a big golden stardust. I can't remember what these are called, Nova lights, but I imagine they're like big chunks of fairy dust. And of course she's taking care of snails and butterflies as well. I went with a monarch butterfly because the color scheme fits the animal fairies the most. Though of course animal fairies would take care of all animals no matter what color they are. And by the window we have some mushrooms growing in, and again more mushroom lights. And one of my favorite items, the wooden deer wall hanging, which I really, really love. I think it's so gorgeous. And in this corner over here, we have the area where she takes care of birds. So we have a birdhouse and a cuckoo clock, which I pretend is just like another birdhouse on the wall. She has some berries and some wood. And of course, she's taking care of another bug, a little red dragonfly. And of course, she has the little cat item. I can't actually remember what this item's called, but I love it. It like bobbles its head when you touch it. And let's not forget the designs on the floor. So she has a little bunny popping out of its hole over here, and lots of golden and red autumn leaves inside. She also has a squirrel on the floor and a little bird over there, as you can see. And in the center of the room, of course, is the mushroom table where she can sit here with her animal friends and her fairy friends, have tea and a snack and work and do whatever she needs to do at this table. I love the mushroom table, and I will continue to use it in as many builds as I can because it's so adorable in all the colors. Maybe the green one's not my favorite, but I just think this came out so lovely. I hope you guys like it. I know, like I said, it's very discombobulated. A new word to add to our dictionaries. But I like it. It's messy. It's fun. It really does feel like a little fairy's home to me. And I personally love how it came out. So I hope you guys liked how it came out too. Let me know in the comments if you liked it and which type of fairy home you'd like to see me create next. I'm thinking a wind fairy home would be really great for Halloween time. Let me know if you'd like to see that. And before I say my goodbyes, let's take a look at some of your builds that you did this week. First up is Petachu's design. They said, isn't it obvious that I love to decorate bedrooms? So I imagine like a full fall-themed fantasy hollow in the stump of a tree. I really love fall, and pumpkin pie is my favourite part. Soleil? I'm sorry, I don't know how to say her name, is making some for all of us too. Look how adorable this is! That is so cute. I love your choice of villagers. I love the pumpkins. Everything is so beautiful. I love all the orange colors. This is absolutely beautiful. Next up is Stella, and they said, I don't have New Horizons, but I tried my best to make a fairy camp featuring Bo. It's not much, but it's definitely my style for autumn. This is absolutely adorable. I love all the items you used. It feels so cozy and lovely. And decorating inside the cabin in Pocket Camp is actually so difficult, so you did an amazing job. I love this so much, and Bo is so adorable. Next up is Corby, and they said, making wishes with my baby Bo on the Enchanted Forest. Can you believe the designs you used in this one is absolutely beautiful? The ducks and the little bow in the river, the glowing reindeer. This is so gorgeous with the pumpkin trees. Oh my god, I'm in love with this one so much. Next up is Ares or Ares? I'm sorry, I actually don't know how you pronounce your name. They said, after much consideration, Roma decided to follow her girlfriend deep inside the forest where she resided. She tried to keep on a brave face, but she couldn't help but be scared of the dark autumn trees and eerie sounds that played in the night. Eventually, the princess was led to a pumpkin carriage behind old stone structures and a well that looked like it hasn't been used in decades. Along with two moons that astonished her, Pumpkin was cheerful and told Roma that this will be their means of transportation to get to another area. Roma sighed, but her heart felt warm at the hard work Pumpkin put in to make sure tonight was extra special. With a soft smile, she grabbed onto Pumpkin's hand and entered the carriage. This one has a love story behind it. I can't believe this. I'm so in love with this. It's so beautiful. It feels so magical. I love this. And I love that when you guys give me a backstory for your builds, it's so lovely. I love this one so much. And finally, we have Sarah's design, and they said, I found a mushroom village ruled by little gnomes. Each gnome has its own work to do every day, and they kindly welcomed me, and we had so much fun together. I am absolutely obsessed with this one. I love the gnome characters. Oh my goodness, I love that they all have different jobs to do. This feels so magical with all the mushroom items, the well, the design of the water under the bucket, the gnomes, the little gnome cooking, and like everyone dancing in a little circle. I'm so in love with this. I can actually cry. It's so cute. So thank you so much to all of you who took part this week. I do really appreciate every single one of you that takes part every single week. And as you guys can see, if you aren't part of my Discord server, you should definitely join, because everyone in my Discord server is so amazing at decorating in Animal Crossing, like way better than me. Thank you so much for taking part, everyone. I really appreciate it. Seeing your builds makes me so happy and inspires me so much. So thank you. Okay, so I think we're about done now. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I adore filming these fairy speed builds, and I hope you love them just as much as I do. Before I go, I do just want to say an extra special thank you to my Patreon supporters for supporting me this month. I really do appreciate your support so, so much. I feel like I say the exact same thing in every single video, but I really do appreciate your support. It means so much to me. So thank you. And to everyone else, thank you so much for watching too. Hope you're having a super lovely day. If you enjoyed this video, please do consider leaving a like and subscribing, because it really does help me out. Hope you have a super amazing day. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you in my next video. Bye.